Okay, I got two bush beans down here where those little tomato sticks are. One, I don't know if I can see it, somewhere down there, and one over there in the shade are these Arikara beans. And then I got Good Mother Stollard right down here. And going up that way, doesn't look all that great right now, but hopefully it'll come out better, because I got Tiberius and Canali runner beans. Two over there, and then right there. And got a little walkway in the middle here. When the beans start coming out on the vine, they'll grow up high, and then they'll go across. I mean, at that time, the strings will get tightened better also. They're loosely put on here right now. Okay, this is all dirt farmer farming. I got the Tiberius beans down there, two down there, and I got the strings going back there. One of those dirt farmer fences I put down there. There's a full garden going to you. So when they start growing, they'll latch onto there. We got sweet pea. We got two sweet peas in that corner one down there growing. The Akira. That's a black-eyed pea. I got two or three black-eyed peas down there. Then I got a sweet pea there, but this floods over here, so I don't know if that one will even grow. All right, now I got to watch all this string as I walk around here. In about 2 weeks or so, it should look a lot different. This is purple hull pea. Purple hull pea in these little round chicken wire baskets, and purple hull pea. And then we got two sweet peas in there growing. I've got Trail of Tears, two in there. Trail of Tears right down here. I can't see if I'm pointing on there. Down there is two. And then up here I got two down here with this dirt farmer fence. Two down there with that dirt farmer fence. Oh gosh. No brace. I can't bend my knees. I'm doing a really fabulous job. Sweet pea right here. And nothing's growing out there yet. This is black eyed pea. Black eyed pea is growing here. I believe that's what it is. I could be wrong. You know what? When everything grows, I'll know what the hell it is. Then we got 140 garlic right here in between. We got, this is too many. I put four or five seeds for cucumber. Instead, I'm going to plant them right there where those holes are. This is a cantaloupe. This is the only one that's growing. I put two seeds down there. There's only one growing. I put two seeds down there. Nothing yet. Then I have Jubilee and Sugar Baby watermelons. Which is which, I don't know. But I put two seeds down there. Nothing. Two seeds down there. Nothing. Two seeds down there. Nothing. And miraculously, I have three seeds growing right there. So might have to kill off one of those. I don't know. Eggplant back there, it's not growing. I got other seeds I'm going to put out instead, fresher. Then I have, it looks like crap, it really does. But when this stuff grows up, it'll be overwhelming. Okra. That's one, two, I got two, four, six, eight, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20 okra out here. And, I have four green and four yellow zucchini right here. And then again, as I said before, I put that's a torch stuff I'm gonna let keep growing. That cinder box I'm gonna get out of here though, but that'll be right here, a big bushy sunflower. The orange flowers with the hummingbirds, honeybees get on a lot. These windmills are gonna have to come up because they'll scare off the birds and the bees, which are needed to pollinate everything. And over here, so far my wife's got, I think, 8 tomato plants out here. We got so many more that's gotta come out here. Got one there. One there. This one's right in front of me, right down there. One. Be careful. One right there. Going further east, right over there is one somewhere. I can't see it on the lens. I think it's in the center there. Going back north. There's one plant down there. Yeah, I can see that right there. small one planted right there. And a small one planted right in there. So there's one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, somewhere eight. And we might put pepper plant, we might put pepper over there, one. Put a pepper plant down over there somewhere. I can't see in here, two. Plus, like I said, we got about 12 more tomato plants in there. And we have all this space out here. We have about 20 feet at least in the middle here for peppers and tomatoes. And we'll plant stuff around the back. Maybe not the last 10 feet back, pepper plants can go all the way across. Jalapeno peppers, I planted four jalapeno peppers. I planted two bell peppers, two orange bell peppers, two King of the North peppers, and two other peppers. A lot of peppers. They gotta be plants before they're put out here. Even if they're small, they'll grow really good. Like, see, that's kind of perfect. You want your tomato plant to be a little bit bigger than that, but that's fine too out here. These were planted about 4 days ago, 5 days ago. It rained a little bit too, and they're fine. So, like I say, if you look at the areas out here, like around where that hook is, I'm gonna put a pepper plant over there, and then go up a little bit, almost to the cement rocks right there. Put a pepper plant back there. I could put another tomato plant. Where's this one? I can't see it. This viewfinder again. Anyway, off in there, about 8 feet over. And back there, another one, two, three, back there, four, five, six. Yeah, we can get tomatoes in here and then peppers in the middle. So, but these windmill flowers, they're gonna have to be moved away from here, because like I said, when the flowers are coming out, you want your bees, the bees won't be bothered so much, but the birds might. So right now there's 20 of these around the garden. This is the east wind, and oh, my sunflower wall or fence is doing really good too. These are 99% yellow sunflowers, but I have a couple of the tall ones are the torch sunflowers, which are the big bush. And we transplanted these out of the garlic, and they're hanging in there. There's one there, one up there somewhere, one up there in the edging, three right here, and you got one right there, four. One somewhere in there, five. So that's the torch sunflowers, plus the yellow sunflowers all in here. Yellow sunflowers. That's a torch, the tall one right there is a torch. So these are all yellow sunflowers. And then I had planted torch by seed here. And I don't know if I didn't do it right or if they were left. There were seeds from heads of the flower from last year. And I don't know if they'll grow or not yet. There are some that have come up, so they may not grow right here. This should be yellow sunflowers in the corner here, the northeast corner. But as you go along the northern wall here, I can look at the leaves generally and see that this yellow sunflower. Yellow sunflowers have the round leaves. Again, I can't see on the screen, but if they get the pointed leaves, that's usually the torch sunflowers. My wife transplanted a couple of torch out here just this morning. See, but it looks like it's wilted, but it will come back probably. This one right there looks wilted. I don't know if it's on the screen. But you water them and they'll come back in a couple days. That should be a torch down there, a small one. Most of these, again, this is kind of tricky. I think this is the yellow sunflowers. It might be torch, but this is the northern wall. I wanted the torch ones, the big bushy ones out here. Of all the spraying and crap they're going to do. They planted Monsanto corn-like products. Any of those green things you see the sprayed down on the ground? That's a corn-like product from Monsanto. So that's the reason for the sunflower fence, mainly to break that crap up. That's not as bad. The cotton is the most toxic poisons they spray is when they redo cotton. Soybeans is the next. Corn is the least. So they're going to do corn, so the corn will be we'll be so totally isolated out here in July. You won't see us until you get right up. Let's see. I can't even see if this is recording. Yeah, it's recording. Yeah, you won't. We won't be able to see any cars until they get right on the edge there by that tree off the road. Because the corn all over here will be up, and you won't be able to see anything. You won't be able to see anything back there. So, see, there's one torch. It looks wilted, but it'll come back. Torch coming up. Torch coming up. Torch. 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 And like I said, these are close. Actually, these are three of them. Kind of look like they're about a foot apart, or about 18 inches apart. And then when they come out, they'll be on top of one another. Okay, and then I stopped right here. I got a little area where I come in to mow. And then we got the yellow sunflowers, I think. And I might have a couple torches mixed in here. So, and about another, let's see, this is the 17th of May right now. So by the end of this month, I'll know exactly what this is because, you know, the torch, if you've seen previous videos, torch look completely different from the traditional yellow sunflowers. There's like three or four different yellow sunflowers out here too, by the way, so. Heirloom has got a large, wide variety of things. So, you know, I got yellow here, I think, and then I think I did torch, because right there looks like a torch. I don't know if I can see it on there. And these groups together are like yellow. They look like sunflower seeds, like you eat David sunflower seeds. And I just sprinkle them down, and they grow. Sometimes I thought they'd choke each other off. And then there's a break here by CJ, Lucy's and CJ's grave. And just for the lawnmower getting here. And I had this for them specifically, yellow sunflowers on the ends. Over there and right there. And in the middle here, I had planted torch sunflowers again. If I have to transplant some, I will. But I got some more. I got a bunch of seeds of torch. And they'll have to come out this week and get them in here. And maybe by the end of May, they'll be coming up too nicely. And then just yellow sunflowers on the end over here. A little split here. And my elderberry is right there. And right there, I got two small pieces of chicken wire with a couple of tomato steaks holding like a little ring around them. We're going to open those up. We're going to bring black mulch and shovel that around there and make it maybe a little bit wider around there. So they'll have black mulch around them and the elderberries. That one right there is bushed out a lot. They were both put down, you know, see a previous video when they were put down from Stark Brothers, starkbrothers.com. Okay, so that's that. Yeah. This might be one of the last, this might be the last year, I don't know. We're not gonna do anything like this next year, I don't think. I really don't. Because right now, we got all these sunflowers out here. We got these three major gardens. One large one in the back there with watermelon, cantaloupe, and cucumbers planted, tomatoes on the end, okra and zucchini here, and beans and peas in number two. And the garlic in the middle. So, God, I don't know if we'll be able to do this next year at all. Seriously, we might just take half of the back garden and maybe one of these gardens and that's it. Not worry about number two or the eastern half of number three. The sunflowers around the edges, I don't know. We got a tiller. I might till it up and just throw seeds down there and just what grows, grows. If it doesn't grow, that's fine too. Those bushes will keep growing continuously. Elderberry. Might get another berry or something and put it a little bit further north on the other end of that one. So, oh man, that's what we got planted out here right now. Oh, I got onions and I got spinach and lettuce on the side of the house here. Ouch. Yeah, I'm slowing down. I planted lettuce around back. My wife transplanted four of them right back there. I can't see on the viewfinder, but there's four lettuce somewhere back in there. And here on these three little mounds I made, I thought I put spinach on the back one, and then I put two different types of lettuce on the front too. And I just put potting soil on top, made little mounds, and put seeds in them. So if they grow, they grow. If they don't, well, I wasn't really pushing for these to grow here. This is where the peppers were a couple years ago. They didn't do so great, though. The back here is where there's a bunch of lettuce. It's crisp mint lettuce, heirloom from seeds that we put out here. And I just sprinkle them because they're like little granulars of dirt. They're so tiny. So I always put them in the holes. You can see how many are growing up. That one's not so bad. this one either. And then that one there, look how crowded they are. That's why I said my wife was separating some of them. And that one right there. And that one right down there. It's all lettuce. Cool, crisp lettuce. Crisp mint lettuce is what it's called. Crisp mint lettuce, not cool. Crisp mint lettuce, heirloom. And then I had a different type of lettuce in there, which the rain, this floods out here, so that's why they didn't stick so well. And then I had put spinach across the back, and there's nothing but clover in there growing. So this lettuce here will grow. I'm going to try to maybe thin out some of these and put them on the side of the house. And like those others are still taking, so these here too and these here. And then my peppers up here, I get up on the back porch. Damn. Yeah. Walking barefoot is not my ideal way of walking outside anymore. Well, the crap that's sprayed. I've got approximately 12 onion seeds planted in there. I've got bell peppers planted in this one. These are all green, yellow, green bell peppers. I've got green and orange bell peppers. Beaver Dam 2, Cayenne 2, Two King in the North, and 4 Jalapeno. Jalapeno. I don't know if you can see that one. I can't see it on this viewfinder, so. But anyway, I got 4 in that one. It's the biggest one. I got like a triangle almost. I like a cross, rather. Damn it. So that's what we got this year. My emergency water supply is back up to 6,000 gallons. I was a little tipsy the other day, and my wife had it down almost to the bottom, and I turned it on low and didn't think about it. I was going to shut it off when it got down to up to maybe that band, and I went to bed or passed out or however you want to say it, and it filled up all the way to the top. Now I'm way up to the top, but it's like 6,000 gallons back in there again. So for emergency water, we'll have that. It's going to have to be drained again. But we got that emergency water. One way or the other, I'm going to have it. It's a 6,000-gallon tank of emergency water. So anyway, Monsanto corn-like food product. All the way around. It's 340 acres. So grow something, folks. Get a couple of big pots and grow some tomatoes and peppers and some lettuce in one. Even if you have a couple 5-gallon buckets, you can put like eight or ten lettuce in there at least and just continuously grow them. Cut off the leaves as you need them and they'll keep growing. That's the way to do it. So, bought some of this before and put it out there. Previous video you might see. Oh, and that's my kale. I got kale in there growing. 5-gallon bucket. Old eggshells, gotta get rid of that stuff. Proto-grow mixed in gallon water. Bird feed, bird seed. Well, I told everybody what I think they should do or should try. At least you should, don't have to, but I just say you should try it. So when the shit hits the fan or anything major happens, there's only one person that you can blame. That's the same one that looks at you in the mirror when you look in the mirror. So, and you can use ice cream buckets. I just got those because they got holes in the bottom of the pots in there. Foil underneath those too. I don't need to do that, but I did anyway. All these plants, adding in planters and ice cream buckets and stuff. You know, where there's a will, there's a way, folks. Go get these damn things for $3 when they're at Kmart's out of business just about now. But you can get them at the China Mart, I'm sure. 5-gallon buckets. Get you 10 of them and just get, you know, bags of soil. This is my third bag of potting soil. Not much left. I'd like to have one more bag just to do all the plants in the pots. I mean, I'll grow stuff. There's bigger planters down there. You know, just run out of room, I'll put stuff in there. That's a real big, two of these real big ones. You can grow like 2 tomato plants in one, or 1 of the tomato plants good in a big one, or even the one right next size smaller for 1 tomato plant. But you can grow 2 or something in the big ones. But there's no excuse to not do anything like that, really. I mean, geez, we're scraping by on disability that's just barely covering the bills. So if I can do it, then it pisses me off when people say, well, I can't do it. Well, you know what? Just roll over in your wet panties and shut up. There you go. There's a good look at the garden this year for 2018. Next, at the end of this month, I'll come out here hopefully and you'll see green all over out there. I'm going to have to replant some things, but you know, you got what's what out there right now.